documented that domestic violence tends to escalate during the lockdown. It is not just women who are victims, but also police reports that a surprising number of men are reported being battered at home. This vice is made worse by loss of jobs. All this frustration is meted out on family members at home. A reporter has the details.
Counsel Albert Mwebaza, attached to the Uganda Human Rights Fort Portal branch, says the law treats both gender equally. The Domestic Violence Act 2010, Section 4, states that any person who engages in domestic violence can be imprisoned for 2 years or pay a fine of 48 currency coins, totaling to 960,000 shillings, or both.
That any person who engages in domestic violence commits an offense and is liable to imprisonment for 2 years, or a fine of 48 currency points. That is, a currency point stands at 20,000, so you multiply 48 by 20,000 to get a fine, or both.
He says that domestic violence does not only occur in marriages. He encourages victims to report to police so perpetrators are prosecuted.
Us as a human rights, we come in a way that though the Domestic Violence Act created it as an offense and is criminal in nature, the mandate to handle first lies with either the police, where we encourage the victims to report at police so that they are given medical forms, BF3s, they are examined for the extent of the harm occasioned to them, so the case can take its course.
Agnes Ongom, the in-charge of the Child and Family Protection Unit at Fort Portal Police Station, says last month 61 cases of domestic violence were recorded, of which 22 were men. She says land wrangles were among the main causes.
For men, we had an increase in domestic violence, where the number went up to 61. And this time, surprisingly, we had 22 men who reported out of the 61 cases of domestic violence. We had 22 men. And every domestic case we handle, it involved land. People are fighting over land. And I think it's because when COVID started 2020, most people went back home. And the only way of survival was cultivation. So people saw land as the only source of income. Now men and women started fighting for land, and each one wants to get his or her own share.
The land question, land rights. Who owns land, who doesn't? Most men, whenever they want to do something, they look at land as the immediate resource, and at times forget that they share this land with the rest of the members of the family. Especially now for people living as husband and wife legally, that is the married couples under the various types of marriages we have. For you to dispose of land that you own together as a married couple, you need consent of your spouse. And at times this consent, given that the mothers know, look ahead of the future, they want to reserve it for their children. And when this consent is denied, then we have cases of violence. Either the man threatens the wife, says, if you don't stand in my way of selling this land, I will kill you, such things. So all in all, the best thing we can do is sensitize and encourage victims.
Betty Mujungu, a female counselor representing the North Division in Fort Portal City, says domestic violence has skyrocketed during the lockdown. She says there's need to counseling on how to resolve these matters.
In this case, the men have to be helped. Because most of the cases when men suffer violence, when you listen to stories of violence against men, you realize that, it's a fight together between women and men. And usually at the end of the day, I have seen a case in point where a woman almost killed the husband. And the husband was admitted in the hospital for some time. But when you listen to her, you realize that the man has been battering her altogether. And this time she was prepared and ready for him. So basically, I, as a leader, I want to call upon people to be able to understand each other, especially in this season. Be able to understand, we women should be able to understand that, I mean, it is not all there. But we should be able to be patient with each other and also to realize that there are other means. There are other means of resolving conflicts apart from beating each other, apart from killing each other, because violence is violence and it leads to loss. It's painful. There is no person that has ever testified that when you beat me, I feel good because I've been beaten, whether men or women. So it remains violence and it's unacceptable and it's a bad way of managing conflict.
Kind of torture through words and so on that can be in families. Let us bear with one another, even though we don't have enough resources, but let us have peace. This is very unfortunate at such a time to find people fighting, a man beating a woman or a woman beating a man. Let us bear with one another, respect each other, love each other, and share the little resources that we have, so that God enables us to go through these trying moments of the lockdown. So let us live in harmony and in peace, loving one another, respecting one another as adults, and not resort to fighting or even killing each other and beating at each other. That's very unfortunate. We want to be stronger as judge.
So duty bearers, to make sure that there's a lot of sensitization on the dangers of domestic violence, because domestic violence can lead to death. You have had cases where people have hacked each other to death. It is a serious concern that we should all take up and make sure that at least we stamp out this vice.
David Muhumuza says due to stigma, men fear to report cases of domestic violence since they fear being laughed at by society.
Domestic violence has been increasing during this lockdown. Reasons being, men have been working in different places, women have been staying at home. Due to the fact that the lockdown has found all of us home, now women are not ready to stay with their husbands and husbands are not ready to stay with their women. And men are not ready to go to report to police. Some of them, they get that guts to go to the police to report. But the majority of them, they fear to go to the police to report simply because they know they're supposed to be men. Because according to the Ugandan constitution, women were given that opportunity according to women emancipation. So they feel that indeed they are the ones to take over. In case you come home late, your wife will ask you, where have you been? But during the past, they were not asking that because men were the heads of the family.
Spike in domestic violence cases, and it has come to our notice that in the recent past, police has registered more cases of domestic violence, and the complaints are being this time round made by men, which is very encouraging and good, because a lot of men have been suffering domestic violence in silence due to community perceptions that a man cannot complain when they are faced with cases of domestic violence.
There are other means of resolving conflicts. We are aware that this is a very, very tight season. It is a very complicated season where there's a lot of depression, there's a lot of lack, there's a lot of anxiety in families, and families, some people are not used to staying together, but it's a lockdown and people are staying together and there's a lot of need in families. So at the end of the day, there's too much conflict in families. And I am happy that men can report as well.
Jocelyn Chacho, a mother of three, says for some women, it is self-defense.
If you see our four grandfathers and mothers, how they used to treat our mothers, it was too much compared to now. Why? Because now women, I think they have realized their rights. So they're also fighting back because men have really done it in the past so much to women. So I think women are also revenging, not revenging as in revenging, but they have come to realize their rights.
Bishop Ruben Kisembo of Rwenzori Diocese advises couples to seek guidance from elders and religious leaders whenever there is disagreement in a home before it escalates to violence.
Yeah, I want to advise that in case married persons or couples have problems, they can visit us as religious leaders. We can try to help them. They are priests, the archdeacons, the lay leaders everywhere, the elders, their friends. Who could advise, and it's something that you call big can become small. So when you get problems in your house or families, please don't die alone. Before you beat somebody, before you fight, call in some elder or religious leader, to advise you and help you and counsel you, so that you can be able to tolerate each other and live in harmony.
Counsel Mwebaza says, however, there is still a need for gender-based violence well-maintained shelters for victims. He says cases can be reported to the local council three courts before proceeding to higher courts.
Need a proper and well-maintained GBV shelter to house victims of domestic violence. One thing I should also note that the case of domestic violence can also be reported to the local council courts. These are the LOC 3 courts. And when a case is reported, they shall follow the procedure of handling the complaint as it is in the Local Council Act of 2006.
Gender-based violence can include sexual, physical, mental, and economic harm inflicted in public or private. It also includes threats, coercion, and manipulation. This story was compiled by Doreen Nasima for the news in Fort Portal.